mga sulat ni Dr. Jose Rizal, lalong-lalo na sa El Filibusterismo at Nolimitang Here. Isiniwalat ni Dr. Rizal ang mga kawalangyaan na ginawa ng mga fraile sa mga Filipino. Ibinahagi ni Dr. Rizal sa kanyang mga nobela ang katotohanan hinggil sa sitwasyon at kondisyon ng mga Pilipino at ng bansang Pilipinas sa kanyang kapanahunan. Subalit, may lumabas na isyu that Dr. Rizal retracted all of his writings. That Dr. Rizal retracted his attacks against the friars and against the Catholic Church. The question right now is the retraction true? Is the document true? Kaya sa video ng ito, pag-uusapan natin yung retraction ni Dr. Jose Rizal. Pag-uusapan natin yung katotohanan hinggil sa mga dokumento saying that Rizal did retract all of his attacks and teachings that are against the Catholic Church and the friars of his time. Ngunit kung bago ka pa lang sa aking channel, don't forget to hit the like, subscribe, and ring the bell down there para ma-updated ka sa lahat ng videos na aking i-upload. So this is Sir Jun, your philosophy and social science mentor today. Tara na, simulan na natin ang ating discussion. 3, 2, 1... ating pag-usapan ay galing kay Father Manuel Garcia, isang fraile, a Claritian missionary, and this document was accordingly published on May 18, 1935. So, ito yung nasulat dito na sabi nila, sabi ng mga fraile, galing daw ang sulat na ito kay Dr. Jose Rizal. So, ito daw yung sinabi ni Dr. Rizal sa document. I declare myself a Catholic, and in this religion in which I was born and educated, I wish to live and die. I retract with all my heart whatever in my words, writings, publications, and conduct has been contrary to my character as a son of the Catholic Church. I believe and I confess whatever she teaches, and I submit to whatever she demands. I abominate Masonry as the enemy which is of the Church, and as a society prohibited by the Church. The diocesan prelate may, as the superior ecclesiastical authority, make public this spontaneous manifestation of mine in order to repair the scandal which my acts may have caused, and so that God and people may pardon me. This was published by Dr. Rizal, sabi nila, in Manila on December 29 of 1896. This was on the day before his death on December 30, 1896. Ngunit ang katotohanan tungkol sa dokumentong ito ay questionable or doubtful. Bakit? Because there were four iterations, four versions na lumabas hinggil sa dokumentong ito. The first version was published in La Voz Española and Diario de Manila on the day of the execution of Rizal, that was on December 30, 1896. The second text appeared in Barcelona, Spain, in the magazine La Juventud. That was a few months after the execution of Rizal. Particularly, it was on February 14, 1897. And it was published by an anonymous writer who was later known as Father Vicente Balaguer. However, yung original text nito was found in the Archdiocesan Archives on May 18, 1935. So, kung titingnan natin, it was found out, yung original lumabas, 4 decades of disappearance. After 4 decades of disappearance, saka lumabas ang totoong document na galing kay Father Manuel Garcia. i-analyze natin yung document ni Father Vicente Balaguer, the truth of Rizal's retraction is actually questionable. Bakit? Because in Balaguer's testimony, there's only one eyewitness, and that is he himself. Now, sabi niya, Rizal woke up several times, confessed 4 times, attended a mass, received a communion, and prayed the rosary, all of which seem out of character. But since it is the only testimony of allegedly a primary account that Rizal ever wrote a retraction document, it has been used to argue the authenticity of the document. So kaya nga, yung authenticity na naman ng document yung questionable. And of course, since the authenticity of the document is doubtful, then the truth also follows. So titingnan natin ngayon yung primary source na eyewitness account of the last hours of Dr. Jose Rizal. This is coming from Michael Charleston Chua, or si Xiao Chua, my favorite historian, my idol. Shoutout kay idol Xiao Chua. Hello sir, hello proof. A retraction ni Jose Rizal, mga bagong dokumento at pananaw. It was published in the GMA News Online on December 29, 2016. So ang nakasulat dito ay ito. Most illustrious sir, the agent of the Cuerpo de Vigilancia, stationed in Fort Santiago to report on the events during the illegible day in prison of the accused Jose Rizal, informs me on this date of the following. At 7:50 yesterday morning, Jose Rizal entered death row accompanied by his counsel, Señor Tabiel de Andrade, and the Jesuit priest Villa Clara. At the urgings of the former and the moments after entering, he was served a light breakfast. At approximately 9, the assistant of the plaza, Señor Maure, asked Rizal if he wanted anything. He replied that at the moment he only wanted a prayer book, which was brought to him shortly by Father March. Señor Andrade left death row at 10, and Rizal spoke for a long while with Jesuit fathers, March and Villa Clara, regarding religious matters, and it seems. It appears that these two presented him with a prepared retraction on his life and deeds that he refused to sign. They argued about the matter until 12:30 when Rizal ate some poached egg and a little chicken. Afterwards, he asked to leave to write and wrote for a long time by himself. At 3 in the afternoon, Father March entered the chapel and Rizal handed him what he had written. Immediately, the chief of the firing squad, Señor Del Fresno, and the assistant of the plaza, Señor Maure, were informed. They entered death row and together with Rizal signed the document that the accused had written. At 5 this morning of the 30th, the lover of Rizal arrived at the prison, dressed in mourning. Only the former entered the chapel, followed by a military chaplain whose name I cannot ascertain. Donning his formal clothes and aided by a soldier of the artillery, the nuptials of Rizal and the woman who had been his lover were performed at the point of death, in articulo mortis. After embracing him, she left, flooded with tears. Until today, the truth about the retraction of Dr. Jose Rizal remains a controversy. Why it remains a controversy? Because accordingly, it might tarnish the heroism of Dr. Jose Rizal. Sabi nga, kasi Rizal retracted his teachings na hindi totoo. Kasi, ibig sabihin nun kasi ng retraction is wini-withdraw mo yung claim mo. So, ibig sabihin, mangyari nito, kung totoo talaga itong retraction ni Dr. Jose Rizal, so hindi totoo yung mga isiniwalat niya tungkol sa mga injustices at inequalities na naranasan ng mga Pilipino during the time of the Spanish colonization. So, hindi yon magiging totoo if this retraction document is indeed true. You know, but according to some historians, the majority of the historians would actually agree that the document does not tarnish the heroism of Dr. Jose Rizal. Kasi yes, it was published. Kaya natin na na-publish yun and nakita yun ng marami, nabasa yun ng mga maraming Pilipino. However, makikita natin sa kasaysayan that The belief of the Filipinos were solidified. You know, and yung mga Filipinos during his time were actually awakened. Nabuhay sila. So matagal nang nagpagtutulog. You know, they were awakened. Their minds were opened about the truth. Matagal na pala tayong inaapi ng mga Kastila. And that was because of the writings of Dr. Rizal. So, the writings of Dr. Rizal inspired the Filipinos to do the revolution. It pushed them to continue the revolution in 1896 that led to the independence in 1898. So, totoo man o hindi, yung retraction ni Dr. Rizal, nangyari pa rin ang revolution which was led by Andres Bonifacio, diba? Nangyari pa rin yung armed revolution. At dahil doon, nagkaroon tayo ng kalayaan galing sa mga Kastila in 1898.